I just played back the footage for this video and I just want to say the sun is just coming in at me with the blinds closed and you're getting this little pink light right about here and I'm super sorry but there's nothing I can do about it. So please ignore it and continue watching the video. Presentation. Situation. Hey you guys, welcome back to my channel. As you can tell by the title of this video today, we are doing a January favorites and unfavorites slash story time because an unfavorite actually has a story linked to it this time around. So I figured I would just jump right into this video for you guys and tell you what I'm loving this month. First up is a palette. This is a palette I got for Christmas and I'm addicted to it. This is the Urban Decay Naked Heat palette. I love the shades. It's on my eyes today. I really love how the colors complement my skin tone and how they work with my eye color. And it's just a beautiful palette. There's mattes, there's shimmers. It's totally worth the price. It's $60 now. The back of it says Naked Heat. The back of it says, Naked Heats Up, Get Lit with 12 All New, Can't Live Without, Amber Hued Neutrals including Warm Browns, Burnt Oranges, and Rich Siennas for a super smooth red-brown matte and a glimmering copper to a deep shifty bronze. This palette has everything you need to create sultry daytime looks, intensely smoky nighttime looks, and everything in between. I think that's very true. I love this palette. It's very bold. It speaks to me. We have become soulmates. The box is a little weird. I don't like the box. The packaging is the plastic, similar to the Naked Smoky. I like the tins personally, but of course they've changed that. It comes with a brush, giant mirror, and those are all of your shadows. I do really like it. The brush is dual-ended. I haven't used it. I haven't really used any of my Urban Decay brushes. They just kind of exist, so it is what it is. I have kept the box for now. I'm probably gonna get rid of it, but I wanted to keep it for the sake of this video. Another makeup item I'm loving is a concealer, which was gifted to me from KT Lifestyle. It is by a Korean brand. I think it's K Beauty, and it is in the shade number 1. It's literally called Matte Concealer. And it's a really pale concealer. I use it under my eyes. I use it on my acne. It is super high coverage. It's actually apparently rather affordable. I will do my best to link it down below, but this was a gift from KT Lifestyle and I'm super grateful for it and it's awesome and I love it. It's become one of my favorite concealers. This and the Tarte Shape Tape, which I did not include in this video because I'm saving it because I've only used it like twice because I want to kind of finish this one up before I get into another concealer. In terms of other makeup products, I've been loving the MAC Studio Fix Powder. I have it in the shade NC15. I love it. It's compact. It's a light coverage foundation, or you can use it as a setting powder. It really depends on what you're in the mood for. I tend to use that K-Beauty concealer over my face and just like get rid of any acne or anything and then dust that powder over and have a very light coverage day. It's a great day-to-day look for me. It's minimal makeup. It's super easy. It takes me like 15 minutes in the morning to get ready when I'm doing like a quick get out the door routine, which I kind of extend further on in a morning routine collab that's coming up very soon in February with Shauna Minnie, so keep your eyes peeled for that. And then the other thing I love are my brows. I've been loving the ColourPop brow pencil. I don't even know what it's called, but it's just the brow pencil. I love it. It's super skinny. The nib on it is really easy to control. It's super pigmented. It lasts all day, so I love that. In terms of lifestyle, let's try that again. In terms of lifestyle, I've been loving the gym thing. I've been gymming rather frequently. I started my gym membership in November and I've been going very regularly ever since. I try to hit 4 to 5 times a week at the gym. I was doing 6, almost 7, but I just sometimes you don't have time to fit it all in. Like I try to take Sunday as my day off from the gym, or if there's one night a week where I have like a lot of meetings going on, I don't feel too guilty because I do still manage to go 5 times a week. And I really am trying to get back into that like health and fitness routine and take care of my body and take care of myself because I haven't been feeling 100% lately. I feel pretty dragged down and worn out and I feel like I haven't given myself enough time to recover from like anything. Like Vlogmas took the good out of me, guys, but I'm still vlogging and I'm still enjoying life and there's like other things happening in my world and it's just things are getting a bit hectic. So I feel like having a bit of a balance and taking that time every day to go to the gym and work out is good for me. It's good for my mental health, it's good for my body, and I feel a lot better for it. It takes a lot sometimes to get me there, but luckily William signed up, so he's been motivating me and he'll get me to go, which is great. We try to meet there at least 3 times a week, and then on Thursday nights when we pick up groceries, we go to the gym after and I drive, and then on Friday nights he'll try to drive, so we try to alleviate driving and just kind of, you know, help each other out and work out. So when I go with him, it's fun. When I go by myself, I have to go to the gym in the mall because it has Wi-Fi, so I can catch up on my YouTube videos while I do cardio. I feel like I need things to multitask sometimes just to get everything done and get everything accomplished. Another thing I've been loving this month is my planner. I carry it around with me everywhere I go right now. There's just so much happening. I keep like my whole life organized in this little thing. It says, "And so the adventure begins." It's 2018 calendar. I purchased it back in, I think it was August, and I've been using it. So this is gonna be like the first planner of my life that I actually bought in the first month that it ever came out, and then managed to continue using it like all the way up. So like this, you guys, as an example, was my December. So it's been hectic. I'm now, like I said, into my January, and I've been planning and I've been doing a lot of things. And next weekend I'm having another filming weekend. I have someone coming over to help me film, so I'll hang on a lot more videos that way. This thing is so well loved, it has coffee stains on the inside. Yeah, it's a lot. So if you guys don't have like a planner life, and if you're not like super duper organized but want to try, 10 out of 10 recommend getting one of these. And then I have an unfavorite slash story time to tell you about this month as well, and it's more of a lifestyle product. I've had this for a couple of months. So first off, it is the Drink Up Smart Water Bottle. It's a 500ml bottle, so 17 ounces, and it is basically an insulated stainless steel smart water bottle that changes the way you drink and think about water. That is what the back says. I entered a Facebook campaign for this, so basically it was a referral thing. So if you got 15 referrals, you basically want a free bottle. So I did that. They said they were gonna ship it right away. I did this back in August, and they said they were gonna ship it right away. And every month they had a reason to not ship it. Then finally everybody went crazy the end of November, and they finally shipped them out with FedEx. Anyone who won one in Canada, which seemed to be about half of the people who won one, ended up having to pay anywhere from $25 to $45 in duties. I got dinged with $23 in duties, and I ripped this company apart because it was a free gift. I didn't actually buy anything. Why should I have to pay for it? Anyway, everyone kicked up enough of a stink that the company actually paid us all our duties back. So that was cool. That came in through PayPal. So it wasn't like a refund on my Visa, but that's okay. I could still buy something else with it. It was fine. It's all good. So I got my money back for that. So then making the bottle free again. I was so excited to get the bottle, and I've had nothing but problems with it. It's fully charged. I've followed the manual. I've contacted tech support about 18 times since I got it. And it doesn't log your water, even though it says it does on the top. It's supposed to sync up with an app. My app keeps dropping it all the time. I've done everything and more that they've asked me to do, and it just doesn't work. So I've stopped using it as a technology bottle and have just been using it as a stainless steel bottle. It has a computer on the inside and the cap, and it has like a charging port and stuff. So it lights up when you unscrew it, and it's supposed to, when you fill it with water, be able to read the volume of the bottle. Obviously. So it's quite simple. And then when you consume water, it's able to tell how much of a percentage of the water you consumed based on the volume of the bottle. Mine hasn't done that. I've drank the whole bottle in like before I put the cap back on. Like, so I filled it up, screwed the cap on, and it says I've drank 0% water. I've then drank the entire bottle and put the cap back on, and it still says I drink 0% water. I've done it in intervals, like have a mouthful, put the lid back on kind of thing, and it never sinks. So I still have to open the app manually and tell it I drank a full bottle of water. And then it'll tell the cap I drank a full, so it's not working basically. I've gone back and forth with the company. They keep saying everything is running fine on it. I don't know if anyone else is having complaints. Like, it's just been a really crappy experience. So if you're thinking about getting a smart water bottle, my advice to you would be, do not use the Drink Up smart water bottle. I think you should go look at the Hydrate Spark instead. I think they're the only two on the market right now. I'm disappointed in it because I'm a very techie person, and to have a piece of technology that doesn't work properly is really annoying. But at least I didn't pay for it. I got it for free, so that's a good thing. So I would say avoid that like the plague. I think it's like a $100 bottle. So anyway, I'm gonna keep hoping that they like do a new firmware update or a new software update and it fixes the glitch I'm having. So I'll keep using it, but right now it's got like a -5 review for me because it doesn't do anything it says it's gonna do. And it's really annoying. So anyway, I did get the coral color, by the way. And that's it. This basically, oh, the way it reminds you to drink is it'll actually send a notification to your phone, and it tells you to literally drink up. It's called the Drink Up bottle. So yeah, it'd be cool if it worked. Right now it doesn't work, so that's rather annoying. And then the other lifestyle change that I've been doing is I've been trying to cut back on coffee, and it's been a struggle. It's been like the biggest unfavorite thing of my life. I'm down to like 3 cups a day, which I think is a reasonable number of cups of coffee. And if I need to taste coffee late at night, I'll drink decaf. But it's, which I still think decaf coffee should be illegal. But I'm struggling with it, and I can tell the difference. Like, I don't like it. Like, it just, it tastes horrible in comparison. Even though I don't think it should. But in my head, it does. So I made the switch to tea, so I'm trying to like eliminate like 3 cups of coffee a day by drinking tea. And the tea that I've been drinking is the David's Tea Birthday Cake Tea. I've tried Vanilla Swirl, I've tried a couple and I don't like them. But I do really like Birthday Cake. It takes me a lot longer to drink a cup of tea. I've been sipping on that same cup now for 4 hours in the thermos and I still struggle to get it down, but it's not horrible. So I've been drinking tea and trying to make my life a little better without coffee, and it's been sad, I'm not gonna lie, I've been struggling hardcore. But overall, I will survive. But that's pretty much it for me for this January favorites. Leave me a comment down below telling me what you were loving this month. If you guys have any tea recommendations, can you leave them down below, because I'm really trying. I hate the smell of orange pekoe, it makes me gag, no matter what brand, so don't even bother to leave those, because that just doesn't work for me. Give this video a thumbs up, hit subscribe, turn on notifications, and I will see you all in my next video. I love you guys. Bye!